The comeback of Japan is underway, and people near and far are taking part. Across the country, students from overseas continue with their education. On today's Manabiya, we'll meet a student from Italy who's learning manga in Kyoto. Manabiya is all about overseas students living and learning in Japan. First up, school days. Keeping up with what's going on campus. Kyoto is not just a city in Japan. It's a place that's known and loved around the world. Japanese tradition resides here as part of everyday life. Traditions come in many forms. They attract people from other countries who want to learn about them in their natural habitat. People like this young woman from Italy.
ルス・ダニエラと言います。京都に来てから4年になります。
Daniela has made good use of those years in Japan. Her language skills have come along quite nicely. The 22-year-old attends Kyoto Seika University.Majoring in one of the more recent artistic traditions to come out of Japan. Kyoto Seika University started offering instruction in manga in 1973, the first university in the country to do so.The curriculum includes courses for those who want to become professional manga artists. But it also has classes for students who want to get involved in editing. People can also learn how to express irony and humor in a single picture, and how to put pictures into motion through animation. About 60 students from abroad are learning about manga here.They come from such places as China, South Korea, and Sweden. And, of course, Italy, Daniela's home country. She's enrolled in the comic art sequence to become a manga artist and has been at it for 2 years.
So, I'm now in Nemutsu. Nemutsu is the first stage of the plot を作った後に一番最初に作るこういう紙で書く、まあ、なんというか設定とか基本っても言えるかな。
The assignment for this day was to draw 8 manga pages in line with a particular theme. This requires not only deciding the story development but also figuring out how to set the range for the pictures, the size for dialogue and the locationsDaniela does her project in Japanese. The professors in this department are practicing manga artists, whose work is seen across the country. They know the ins and outs of the industry. So, when they give advice, it's based on experience.
はい、この間お話しした話とちょっと変わったんですけど、はい、まあそのおもちないとか、うん、そういうトリコは残ったままですけど、
なんかこれだと説明を読まないと二人の関係がわからないように、なんか転んで泣いてきた
み
たい
なのかもしれないし、こういうメスメス泣いてるんじゃなくて、こういうシーンを見せればいいってことなんでしょうか。
やっぱり漫画の表現というのを考えると、大事なところは絵で直接的に見せてほしいっていうところではあると思うんで。
The teachers cast a critical eye on everyone's work. International students get no slack.
これ下のところを消して、まあ、なんとかなりますね。
Repetition helps develop the skills needed to develop a reputation. So the students draw over and over to reach the essence of the subject. When Daniela goes home, she's still surrounded by manga. Her monthly living expenses amount to just under $1,500. About $600 of that goes to rent. All those manga she buys up add up too.
イタリア人が、イタリア捨てて日本に来るなんてちょっとありえないんでしょ？漫画家目指すなんて。
Daniela was born and raised in Monza, a suburb of Milan. As a girl, she loved drawing. She started watching Japanese anime and reading translated manga. Before long, that world had become her world. She studied Japanese by herself in her teens and learned enough to understand some manga.
ある日高校生の時池山田吾という漫画家さん の作品で会いまして、モイカレという作品で本当に圧倒されたっていう感じで、まさになんか人生を変えられたっていうか、うん、本当にそれはなければ今頃まだイタリアにいますかもしれない。
モイカレ is a love story about a girl like Daniela who's crazy about manga.Daniela was drawn to this tale of dreams and romance, but she also found that it made her aware of cultural differences.
文化が違うからかな。本当に漫画も王なんだけど、アニメ、特にアニメの王なんですけど、子供だけのためだと思われて、そのためにまあカットシーンとかされたり。セリフを丸逆にしたりとか、本当に残念なことに内容と本当に一変するっていうか、うん、だからね、そういう違いに気がついて、あ、本当に違うんですよねって思って、あ、やっぱり日本語の方がいいんですよね。そこからまあどんどんまあ日本語に興味を持って、もちろん日本にもですよね。
The obvious path for her was to study manga in Japan. And in Japan, Kyoto Seika University is the place to go to do just that. To pave the way, Daniela needed to build up her communication skills in Japanese. So, for her first 2.5 years in the country, she attended a language school.
京都はとても好きで、東京に比べたら本当に静かで、私の住んでた町にとても似てていい感じです。ほらね、駅はすぐ近くなのにまあ静かですよね、うん、
She now sees Kyoto as her other hometown. Part of the reason is that she's been there quite a while. But her attachment to the city goes far beyond nostalgia.This is Japan's first manga research facility. It was established by Kyoto Seika University and the city of Kyoto. And its influence reaches around the world. 50,000 manga line the walls, a historical record of an art form that's still evolving. Manga are now found in places across the globe. They make for a multi-million dollar business in markets such as the United States and France.Daniela says the institute reminds her of just how prominent the profile of manga is internationally.
あ、そっか、これもあったけど、イタリアにも。でもこれ雑誌って言えるかどうか、この2つあった。私にこれだけ影響を与えてくれた、そんな漫画家さんのように私もなりたいって思ってます。私も誰かに一人もいいからそんな風に影響を与えたいって思ってます、うん、
From a dreaming girl to a woman with an actual career Daniela still has a ways to go in making a living and a life as a manga artist. But with every day, the picture becomes more realistic.
やっぱり自分の夢をちゃんと叶おうと思って、自分の目標を目指そうという強い意志がなければこういうことにはならなかったかもしれないしね。それがあったからこそ両親もちゃんと賛成してくれた。まあ、今も応援してくれてるし、留学しようと思ってる人もにもそういうことは本当に痛いところですよね。ちゃんと自分の考えてること、自分の夢を諦めないでよ。そう簡単に諦めないでよ。ちゃんと目指せ、目指せ。そうですよね。うん。
Even at an early age, Daniela had a sense of where she was headed. Manga became part of her childhood. And when she got older, she found the courage to follow her dream to the other side of the world. Her story continues to be written in Japan. Before we go, here's a bit more information about what you saw today. The manga department at Kyoto, where Daniela studies, encourages applications from international students. The process requires sending in information and documents, and later, an interview in Japanese, along with a review of your portfolio. Classes are all in Japanese, so you'll need to draw on all your language resources. See you next time on Manabia!